Today we are going to learn how to make puris. Puri is a deep fried bread made from whole wheat flour which has originated from the Indian subcontinent. Usually it is eaten with potato curry called potato sabji. You can eat with any delicious Indian curry also. To make the dough for puris we need whole wheat flour, all purpose flour, oil, salt, sugar and water. I use Sujata brand atta, which is a whole wheat flour. I buy this from the Indian store. And we need oil for deep frying. Take a large mixing bowl and add a whole wheat flour to this. I am going to use 4 cups of whole wheat flour today. I make puris on a weekend, so I make a little bit more and keep it. You can just use 2 cups of flour if you don't want to make a lot of puris. I am adding 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. I am adding all-purpose flour so the puris will puff up nicely. Now I am adding 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil to this. Adding oil binds the dough. Now add 1 teaspoon of salt and add 1/2 teaspoon of sugar to this. I am adding sugar so the puris will have a nice golden color. Mix it nicely before you add water to this flour. Heat 1.5 cups of water in the microwave for 1 minute and add this lukewarm water to the dough and mix it nicely. If you need little bit more water, just add like 1 or 2 tablespoons of water to this. For 4 cups of flour, I am using a little more than 1.5 cups of water. If you are going to use only 2 cups of flour, add 3/4 cups of water and a little bit more, maybe like 1 or 2 tablespoons more. Just in case it becomes sticky, add more flour to this, that's all. 4 cups of flour makes approximately 20 to 25 puris. Nicely knead the dough now. The secret of the puri lies in the kneading of the dough. So knead the dough until it becomes solid and smooth. The consistency of the dough is very important when you make the dough. Once the kneading is done, you can close it and keep it for 1/2 hour. After opening, knead the dough once again and then make sure the moisture is all gone. And then roll the dough into small size balls. You can make golf size balls rolling nicely between your hands. They should look like this. Now we can start rolling the balls. I meant the puri dough, not the golf balls, and you don't have to go to a golf course to roll it. I usually dab the balls with the all-purpose flour and then roll it with the rolling pin. You can roll it to 4 to 5 inches round shape. I usually roll the dough balls and keep them on an aluminium foil and then start deep frying. I lay the rolled dough on an aluminium foil like this. This works best for me because when I make them and keep it, it's easy for me to deep fry when the oil is hot and I can finish the work fast. Take a deep pan, we call this kadai, and fill this with a lot of oil and heat on medium flame. When the oil is getting heated up, I'm almost finishing with rolling all my dough balls. Now the oil has been heating for 3 to 4 minutes. You can test the oil by putting a small piece of dough and see when it rises up, and then you know that the oil is hot. Add the puri in the hot oil slowly. Gently press down the puri with the back of the spatula. The puris will puff up nicely like this, filling steam inside. It will puff up like a balloon. My kids used to love watching me make puris when they were little. But please be careful with the kids because the oil is extremely hot, and please be very cautious when the kids are around. Look how beautifully it's puffed up. Without any hesitation, I can always say that this one little bread is treasured and loved by all Indians. You can make this for breakfast or indulge yourself for an evening snack, or you can make it for lunch, dinner, or you can take it for picnics, and you can make it for special occasions like birthdays and weddings too. Look how nicely the puri has puffed up. Transfer this to a bowl and then you can add paper towel to drain the extra oil. Your world famous puris are ready to enjoy. Make these puris and let me know how it turned out for you. You can make potato sabji and eat with puris. I will teach you how to make potato sabji in a different video. I can 100% guarantee you that you're going to love my recipes and you're going to enjoy them with your family.